A historic night. It's 60 in a row for Penn State with regard to duels. It comes to an end. ASU beats the number one team in the land. Ken Chertow, Anthony Robles, I'm Daron Sutton, and it was incredible. It started at 125. We'll let you start, Anthony. Brandon Courtney with the strong major.
Well, Courtney was the guy that had to set the pace early for the Sun Devils. Right off the whistle, he started off on his attacks. Great offense on his feet. He did not let up on that pressure. Continuing looking for scores. He's right there getting some big near fall points. Huge win for the Sun Devils at 125 to start off this match.
But it was a bounce right back for Roman Bravo Young, a decision at 133.
Yeah, I mean, he left points on the table for Penn State. Kramer kept it close, and it was a great performance there for Arizona State. Even though he lost, he kept the match tight.
And I think that's a key point. Kramer did a lot of work, real blue-collar work. Minor turns like that turned out to be the difference in this match. We'll share with you some of the other turning points. You thought, though, that this tech fall for Nick Lee at 141, ooh, that might have pushed Penn State forward.
Well, Lee did a terrific job of just stealing the momentum from the Sun Devils. You see right there, dominating performance, was getting to his offense on his feet, grinding out in that top position, working on that chicken wing, getting those near fall points. Big tech fall for Penn State. Way to bring them back into the match and steal that momentum.
Kenny, it was back-to-back wins then for ASU. First at 149, a decision for Josh Maruca.
Yeah, a hard-fought decision, too. He beat a great Penn State wrestler, and that was the only takedown he gave up there. The rest of the match was all Maruca with two takedowns and a ride.
Jared Verglieren was on the other side, but it was a victory. And then Jacori Teemer, Anthony, at 157. He was victorious over Bo Pfeiffer.
Well, Teemer was fired up for his home debut. You see right there that blast double. Such amazing offense on his feet. Again, another not singling on the edge of the mat, finishing up for another 2 points there. He had some great offense. He slowed down a little bit, but then when he needed to, he kicked that offense going again, finished off strong.
And again, keeping it at a decision is all that occurred here, but that was again key. Vincenzo Joseph victorious, but at a decision.
Yeah, that was a great fight right there. That could be the NCAA semis or quarters. And Penn State came to wrestle well, and Shields got handled there.
And then at 174, Mark Hall, a major.
Well, Anthony Valencia, you see right there that blast double, taking Hall onto his heels, onto the mat. Valencia started off this match strong, but Hall took over. You see that composure of the national champion right there, scoring 2 points in the edge of the mat there. Finished up strong in the top position, a hard ride. Way to keep his composure, come back from that adversity, get a big win for Penn State.
We did not get to see Zahid Valencia wrestle. It was disappointing. It was a forfeit. The decision was made. He came out. Neither Shakur Rashid, who hadn't wrestled, or Creighton Edson, the much younger wrestler. That turned out to be one of the big differences in this match. Then at 197, Kordell Norfleet.
Yeah, he wrestled great. That was a huge win for Arizona State. That technically on paper, that's an upset. I thought he would do very well, and he did. You see those blast doubles. Very impressive performance. That was if I could single out one impressive bout, that was a key swing match in the total dual meet.
And then Tanner Hall had to wrestle smart. He fought for the victory, didn't get it, but he kept it at a decision against Anthony Kassar, and with that, it was over.
You see, that was a scary moment just a second ago for Hall. Kassar had him in a nice position, almost pinned him, but Hall fought back. See right there, 2 points at the edge of the mat. Hall fought from start to finish in this match. He fought through the off his back. He had the heart. He said, you know what, I'm fighting for my team. I'm going to keep it going. Way to scrap out there.
And this crowd was incredible. It needs to be pointed out, 8,522 fans were on hand. You can see the results and how it came together. Ken, Anthony, and Daron, ASU makes history here in Tempe, Arizona on a spectacular fall night. Oh, the sport is strong in the state of Arizona.